Yeah, g'day, fellow hustlers. It's Shadow here. This will be the first of a few videos I'll be doing over the long weekend. I'm going to start off doing a demo on how I do djembe, as I think it's rather important at the moment, and a lot of people are neglecting it, including myself, mainly because you need to adjust your squat a lot. It's a pain in the ass changing gear all the time, so I kind of neglected it because I can't be bothered changing all my gear up. So I've already changed it for now, so I can't show you what my original setup is, but I can show you what I use for djembe. So I start as my tank. This is the tank I always use, standard Splash X with the Ruin. Really good armor. So it starts with 9,000 armor, then you add 2,500 with that red gem. And a second red gem down there, another 2,500. So he's fairly strong, he lasts quite well. And he's got the Chain Lightning, which is probably one of the best artifacts out there at the moment. I'm running a second, one of four mages. That's using the new damage weapon. I'm using this because of the insta kill when the target's less than 35%. That seems really handy. With everyone, with a lot of people using Andrika's armor, which is really, really high health, 35% kills pretty quick with those guys. I've got my standard res mage with tank armor, and that's once again got really strong armor. And that one's using the Spellcaster. Got a stun mage. Stop damage happening to my guys. Oh, I should have mentioned, I already said that one there. That's using the Dragonfire. Got a Restore mage. Now, I'd like to be using, this is someone I don't normally use, I'd like to be using another Spellcaster, but I don't have one at this level, so it'll be good to have a second Spellcaster on this one rather than the Snail. But the Snail can pop out some health, so that's handy. Single Archer with splash damage, and it teleports, does the extra damage when it teleports as well. It's also got the Dragon Ring and the Lunar Lamp Amulet, so we can be pretty deadly when he teleports behind the lines. So that's the standard crew I'm sending up. Now, additional to that, this mage, I'm only taking this one because, to be honest, I don't have any other gear for anyone else, so this is just a bit of a haphazard person that I've just thrown in there, just to take someone just in case I need to fill a slot. And it's just a damage mage. Then I've got two guys in the training room over here that will soon be level 100, so I'll be able to change their equipment, but for the time being, one's got heal, and got the time distortion in case I lose my mage that has time distortion. Second one's another resurrect. So I'm taking the second resurrect. And it's also got that unpleasant surprise to control someone. I don't use that normally. I don't think it's that effective. And hiding up here, I have a second tank. Just on the off chance that my tank goes down and doesn't have time to res. And that's got a healing minion. Okay. We might as well get started. I'll just hit previous squad. That'll add the four I've used before. It's quite handy. It's a good little function of adding into it. When you go to your spells, just hit fill. I'm actually thinking for the first time, I'm going to go through. Let's cancel that. For the first time, I'm going to go through with no spells. The second time, man. I'll take you through with spells, so we'll see how far we can get with no spells. and then we'll see how far we can get with Core Free Space. Anyone wondering about the music in the background? Yeah, that's cool. 46 and 2 is that song. Now, something I haven't done, which I should be doing, and I do after this fight, is rearranging the position of my mages. It's actually quite important to have them in the right spot. So, where this guy is here, I'll put him there, you there. That should put this one at the top of the screen, which seems to be where most of the damage is done. And if I'm going to have a mage die, I want it to be this one. So it brings up the healing minion. We'll just double check that. Yeah, so that's got her at the top, which is exactly where I want her. So if I'm going to lose a mage, it's going to be her, and she'll bring out a healing minion to give my guy more health, which is quite good, what you want. Bit of Alice in Chains playing in the background now. So we're going along alright so far. This is at the point I'd like to get after winning this fight, is when I'd start to maybe use a spell or two. But being as I didn't bring any spells this time, we'll just keep going as is. You're not going to get the same results every time you go through Jumbo. You're going to come up with certain opponents that have certain abilities that you're not going to do as well against. And seem to find the more people you come up against that have the dragon artifact, the harder it is, because those ones seem to drain your energy quite a lot. We've had quite a bit of luck this time. So we've already had 11 victories so far, and we're still going on pretty well. I haven't lost anyone yet. Kind of wish I brought my free spells on this one. I'd still have 12 free spells. Yeah, I'm really annoyed I didn't take any this time. Maybe I should have taken them just in case. No, anyway. Okay, we're in a bit of trouble here now. We just got slaughtered. That was a little bit unexpected, considering how quickly we're powering through everything. So in that last fight, when my tank died, I'd normally use a free spell at that point. Use your time to regen. So that's 12 stages without the use of any spells, which is pretty good, considering. But do a lot better with the spells, obviously. Okay, so let's try that again. Like in the previous squad. And we'll take 12. 12 free spells this time. Let's get straight into it. Once again, I've got to change my position of my mages. So I want that mage up there. And we want that merge there. That keeps my Star Mage and my Res Mage in the middle, which are the two important mages that I don't want to die. I'd want to keep those two as long as possible. If I'm going to lose someone, I want it to be this damage mage here. Or that heal mage here, because I can replace the heal mage is pretty easy. I bought another one with me. Pretty relevant song playing in the background. Tool's sober. I'm definitely not sober right now. I've had quite a few drinks tonight. And we're still powering along, which is okay. That's 6 wins so far. Tank's losing a bit of health, but the rest are still pretty good. You'll see yourself jump up and down. That's because of this armor. You'll see it jump up when the 30% chance of increasing health by 65% kicks in. And then after 10 seconds or after you win the fight, you'll see yourself just drop back pretty dramatically. Okay, so when he dies like that, you hit a freeze. Because you don't want them attacking your mages. I probably could have gotten away with not using one that time. But it's good to get in the habit of getting that freeze when your tank dies. So I've used an extra freeze bow than I want to. But most of my guys have got still pretty strong health, which is really good. It's what you want. Yeah, I just wasted another one then. This is why you shouldn't play the game when you've been drinking. You make silly mistakes. Really, what I didn't want to see was a dragon at that point. That's really, really bad. That's not a good result at all. That dragon just wiped out my entire squad after 11 victories, which is pretty, pretty bad. Not happy with that result at all. Not even gonna waste any of my free spells here. I'm not really worried about this result anymore. I'll just go through and try that again. Frustrating when it does that. Okay, let's go through this again. See if we can do a bit better than 11 rounds with all your free spells. Adjustments here. Yeah. So this is just the first video I'll be doing a series of videos over the weekend. The next one will probably be on squad setups. A lot's happened and changed in the game since I last did a video on setups. There are literally just a ridiculous amount of different types of setups out there now. And whatever setup you make, there will be someone out there who will be able to beat your setup. There are squads, my 2.9 mil can take down, there are 3.5 mil. And there's not many, but there's a couple of squads, like 2.6 to 2.8, that can take down my 2.9 mil squad. One of the main squad setups that can beat me are people that are running 2 damage mages. It seems to be difficult for my guys to get past 2 damage mages. So there's 8 victories so far. I haven't used any spells this time. Going a lot better than I was last round. You can never pick what you're going to get in Gen Bay. You'll come up against harder opponents every now and then. Like you saw last round, I got to level 11 and I got wiped out. Just so happened that someone had a dragon at the worst possible time for my guys. So you see, I've used my first spell at round 10. So I've still got 11 up my sleeve, which is really good. I'm just going to start using them now. Try and keep my guys healthy. Basically, I can use 2 spells now per round and still get past level 15, which is what I'm aiming for. I always aim for level 15 or better. So at the moment, I've still got 9 spells. Take a bit of health off me, but I'm still not looking too bad. So yeah, about now is the time you don't want to hit a dragon. Right up on the last of our spells. That's 14. I should get 15 quite easy with 3 spells left, which is good. It'd be nice to have 2 spells left at this stage because 3.3 mil is going to be pretty hard to beat at this point of the game. But we'll see how we go with 1 spell. But to be honest, 15 rounds, I'm happy with that. That's as far as I get, all in, so be it. I was going to grab him, that's not going to help. Now you can see, when you come up against someone who has the dragon at this higher levels, when you're running low on energy, it can wipe you out pretty quick. I don't like my chances here, but you know, we'll give it a go. And if these guys there to see if we can finish it off, but we won't. So there it is, that's 15 rounds, using 12 free spells. That's a pretty standard squad there. So let's take you through what you get. So that was the first one, 12 rounds, 300 coins. Handful of gems that Tony and I did at the moment, but the dust is what I need. 11 rounds. 250 coins. And the big one, 15 rounds. 550 coins, got a standard scroll. Last time I did this, I got 16 down and I got a blue scroll. Got some legendary dust. I usually get some legendary dust for finishing 15 rounds, but I didn't get any this time. But yeah, if you're aiming for 15 rounds, that's what you should be aiming for. If you can do that twice, maybe if you can do it three times a day, so you do the two free runs and then spend 250k apples, do a third run, you can average 1650 a day, and then you can buy one of those every time you hit hit 11,000 coins. Now, with your gems, I don't recommend upgrading your green and blue gems anymore. I recommend upgrading anything you have that's violet or orange. Save all your dust for your violet and your orange, because by the time you've got enough gold to upgrade one of these violet gems, you'll have enough coins to purchase another one. So don't waste your dust on the lower level gems. Concentrate on saving up enough coins to buy a violet gem. Use all your dust to upgrade the violet gem. And then by the time you've upgraded that violet gem, you should have enough coins to buy another one to start upgrading. Okay guys, that's it for this video. Hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, drop them in the comment section. And I'll try and get to them as soon as I can. Cheers guys, keep hustling.